In this session, we're going to fill up one matrix in a diagonal order. So here is the problem for us. Fill up a 5x5 matrix diagonally with the values 10 and 20 as shown below. So this is a diagonal matrix. Here all the cells are initialized with zeros. Only in the diagonal, in this diagonal we're having 10, in this diagonal we're having 20, and at the intersection we're having the sum of 10 and 20, that is 30. So in this way, the array has to be filled up. So try to pause the video at this moment and try to write the code yourself. Otherwise, we're having the practical demonstration to show you that how to write the respective code for this implementation of the given problem. Here is the demonstration for you. This is the array given to us. And you see, most of the locations of this array is filled up with zeros. And in the diagonal, we're having 10. 10 here, 10 here. Consider 10 right now, please. So 10 here and 10 here. And in this particular diagonal, I'm getting this 20, 20. Previously, it was having 10. That 10, this 20 has got added. So I'm getting here 30 as a cumulative effect. 20 here and 20 here. So in this way, this array has to be filled up. And rest of the locations will be filled up with zeros. So how to get the logic? The logic can be obtained in this way. Say 10 will be placed at 0 row 0 column here, then first row first column, then second row second column. I'm considering here 10 because later we shall go on adding with 20 to get 30 there, and then at the third row third column, at the fourth row fourth column accordingly. So what is the logic? Logic here is that is row number is equal to the column number. Now please consider the logic for filling up 20 there. So here the row number is 0 and the column number is 4. And then for this, its row number is 1 and the column number is 3. So 1, 3. In this way, I'm going for 2, 2 here. Then I shall go for 3, 1 and then I shall go for 4, 0. So accordingly, the row numbers and the column numbers are written. Now, what is the logic behind this? It is very simple. You see, 4 minus row number, you see, 0, 4 minus 0, we are getting 4. 4 minus 1, you are getting 3. 4 minus 2, you are getting 2. 4 minus 3, you are getting 1. 4 minus 4, you are getting 0. So the logic is column number will be equal to 4 minus row. So I got the logic for this diagonal printing or filling up logic with 10 and this 20 fill up logic. Both that logic we have obtained. Now let me go through the programming. But what about this zero fill up logic? You know that whenever, I've shown you this one earlier also, whenever you define one array in a global scope, that means before main, then all its locations by default will get initialized by zero. So I can show you this one. You see, I'm just making this particular part under comment. I'm making this one comment. So it has been commented. So only this part will get executed. You see, only the array has been defined and the current content of the array is getting printed. So let me execute. The value, whatever you are getting, that all the locations are having value zeros. So that's why for the zero filling, I did not to have any kind of separate initiatives because all the locations will have the value zeros accordingly. Okay, now see. So filling up the array contents. So for row is equal to 0 to row 4 and then column is equal to 0 to column is equal to 4. Here I have written column less than 5. So that's why column can range up to 4 because column is incrementing by 1. So if row is equal to column, so that is the logic here. So a row call is equal to a row call plus 10. And here we are having when column is equal to 4 minus row, when column is equal to 4 minus row, you are getting this a row call is equal to a row call plus 20. So in this way, I can write. So obviously, instead of writing this such huge line, I can also make it simple. That is a plus equal to 10. And similarly here also, just I shall put plus here. And here I shall go for plus equal to 20. So in this way, if I go on printing, I'm just executing my program. So compile and run. You see, my array has got filled up accordingly. My array has got filled up accordingly. So in this way, I'm getting the output.
So here we are having this 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. Here 10 and 20 got added, so it is becoming 30. So how to fill up array with this particular logic, we have demonstrated the respective program execution. Please leave your comments below, because if you are having any doubts, any difficulties, if you require further clarifications, please communicate with us. Make the tutorial most effective for you. Thanks for watching.